Peace is a lie.
This must end with blood.
That's a dark road, child. The galaxy will burn. Your friends will burn because you were too weak to save them.
Is this a dream?
You are not dreaming. I can assure you of that.
You.
Welcome back, Revan. Are you ready to talk?
I have nothing to say to you.
Then we go again.
Is that all you got? This isn't the first time a woman with anger management problems has done this to me.
Such defiance. I can feel the hate within you, the taint of the dark side. Tell me, what happened to your partner, Malik?
I killed him.
You killed him? Why?
It's complicated.
Why were you at Nathima? What were you looking for?
Killing me will do nothing. The whole galaxy thinks I'm dead anyway.
Eventually, you will tell me everything I want to know.
Maybe so, but I'm going to make you work for it.
You are strong in the Force. Your mind like a steel trap. But in the end, I will break you.
Lord Nyrus, how much longer will it take?
His pain threshold is high, but I am already pushing him to the limits of what a human can endure. If I press any harder, I risk killing him. We need Revan alive. He is too valuable a resource to throw away. I know this man. His name is Revan. He's a Jedi and a Republic spy.
The Force has shown me that my freedom is drawing near. That my future lies beyond these walls.
Watch him closely. He is powerful and extremely dangerous.
And what does your vision show you? How do you make your quiet escape from this dungeon?
You will understand. In time.
You are strong in the Force. Your mind like a steel trap. But in the end, I will break you.
You will never break him.
Where are you?
I see now. She is coming for you.
There you are. I can sense you now. Hold on, Revan, just a little bit longer. He's here, T3. I can feel it. It won't be that easy. We'll need to scout around a bit, get a feel for this world. Just stay close and follow my lead. We'll be fine. I know, but this is the most direct path to the city. Stay close, T3. And remember what we talked about if we should run into any trouble. I'm sure we can talk about this.
Lie flat on the ground and put your hands behind your head. If not, we'll open fire.
I guess we're doing this the hard way. Now, T3.
Jedi. You're here because of Revan. You've come to rescue him.
I'm impressed you figured that out so quickly.
I didn't figure it out. Revan told me.
If you spoke to Revan, then you must know where he is.
Revan is my prisoner.
Then I order you to set him free.
If you come with me, I will take you and your droid to see Revan. Then he will tell you the truth.
T3's right. We've already walked into one trap today. Besides, I have no idea who you even are.
My name is Skurt. Lord Skurt. And Revan told me you were coming. I think the Force gave him a vision of us working together.
And did Revan also tell you to set an ambush for us?
I had to be sure who you were. And now that I am, I finally understand what Revan meant. He wants us to unite against a common foe, our Emperor, Lord Vitiate. He is planning an invasion of the Republic. Revan wants to stop him, and I intend to help him.
Turning against your own Emperor? Now why would you want to do something like that?
Because the Emperor is mad. He wants to plunge us into conflict that will end with our extinction.
If that's true, then why did you take Revan prisoner?
That was before I knew his purpose out here.
It was you, wasn't it? The one who shot down his ship over Nathima.
Have you been to that world? Have you walked upon its surface?
I have.
That was the Emperor's homeworld. To give himself greater power, he unleashed a ritual that devoured everything. When I saw what happened there, I understood the true depths of his insanity. I realized his mind was so twisted and disturbed that he was not fit to rule, and I swore to find a way to stop him.
How do I know you're not lying to me about all of this?
What do your senses tell you, Jedi? Do I seem to be hiding something from you?
No. You seem strangely calm.
It is because I am telling you the truth. Revan may be safe for the moment, but I cannot free him without your help.
Well, it doesn't appear I have another viable alternative at the moment, so I will work with you, for now. But if you betray me in any way, I will-
Save your anger for the Emperor. He is the real enemy. And to defeat him, and take down the Dark Council, we are going to need to work together. Come. Revan is in the sublevel of that structure. He is being held by a Sith Lord named Darth Nyriss. She's on the Dark Council, and very powerful. I could probably get you in to see Revan, but that won't help get him out of his cell, and it might raise suspicion.
Just take me to Revan, and leave the escape to me.
You can't fight your way through Nyriss's entire army of followers, even with my help. She has hundreds of guards and dozens of acolytes, all trained in the dark side. If we're going to break Revan out, we need a distraction. Something to draw away the attention of the guards while we sneak in.
I assume you have a plan.
I do. I'm going to get the Emperor to help us.
State your business.
I must see the Emperor immediately.
Only those on a Dark Council can speak with the Emperor.
My name is Lord Scourge. I serve Darth Nyriss, and I am here on her behalf.
Wait here.
I am Captain Yari, head of the Emperor's Imperial Guard. Come with me.
You're taking me to the Emperor?
You may speak with one of the Emperor's advisors.
Unacceptable. I did not come here to meet with a servant.
The choice is not yours to make.
I am a Lord of the Sith and an agent of Darth Nyriss. I order you to take me to your Emperor.
The Emperor does not like to be disturbed. If he feels you've wasted his time, you will be punished.
It will not be a waste of his time.
As you wish, Lord Scourge. The throne room lies beyond those doors ahead. There you will find the Emperor, but you must proceed alone. I will not violate the sanctity of that room.
Rise, Lord Scourge, and speak your peace.
My Lord Emperor, 3 years ago, I went to serve Darth Nyriss at your request. I discovered a traitor in our midst, Darth Zedrix, who allied himself with Separatists to kill Nyriss and aided in the escape of the Jedi fugitive, Revan. I executed him for his crimes.
Your service has been noted.
I continue to serve Nyriss after Zedrix's death, and I have now discovered an even greater plot against the Empire.
You should speak to Darth Nyriss if you seek to be rewarded for your findings.
That is not why I have come before you. During my investigation, I discovered that Zedrix was not the only member of the Dark Council to betray you. He was merely sacrificed to keep the involvement of the others secret. Darth Nyriss herself was involved in the plot, and she now has the support of several other Council members.
Who else does this plot involve?
Jedi, my lord. Nyriss has been working with them for months in secret. One of them is already on Dromund Kaas. Nyriss is keeping him tucked away in the dungeon of her stronghold, but I've seen him with my own eyes. They're planning an attempt on your life.
Are you certain of these accusations?
I would stake my life on them, my Lord Emperor.
You already have. Does Nyriss know you are here?
No, my lord. I came to see you as soon as I discovered this betrayal.
You are bold to approach me this way, but you have been exceptionally loyal to the Empire. I will reward your initiative this time. If your information proves to be correct, you will be first in line for Nyriss's seat on the Dark Council once she falls. But first, you must bring the Jedi before me.
Thank you, Lord Emperor.
If your information proves to be false, however, you will suffer a fate more terrible than anything you can imagine.
Yes, my lord.
You took a great risk, but if your information is good, it sounds like you'll be on the Dark Council the next time you and I meet.
What about Nyriss? What will the Emperor do to her?
He will send out one of his spies to verify the presence of the Jedi. If your information checks out, Nyriss will be purged by the Imperial Guard, along with her entire staff of followers. Then you will have your chance to bring the Jedi before the Emperor.
I'd rather not be there when it happens. When will you make your move?
Soon. For now, return to Nyriss so she doesn't grow suspicious. I will tell my people not to harm you. But when the battle starts, try to stay out of the way, just in case.
I can't believe I allowed you to talk me into this.
It was the only way to get you in the building. Now be quiet before you blow your cover.
Welcome back, Lord Scourge. Darth Nyriss was just asking about you.
I've been scouring the slave markets, looking for a worthy purchase. This one will have to do.
Of course, my lord. I will inform Darth Nyriss that you have returned.
That isn't necessary. I will go speak with her myself as soon as I get settled.
Very well, my lord.
If you meet with her, T3 and I had better go with you.
Ridiculous. I would never be so insulting as to bring one of my personal slaves into a meeting with someone of Nyriss's rank.
Then you'd better think of something fast, because if this all goes sour, I'm going to whip out my lightsabers and start chopping off heads.
I didn't bring you here so you could throw your life away, and I have no intention of becoming a martyr.
If you think I'm...
The Imperial Guard, they're here. Follow me, the dungeon is this way. Blast. The whole place is on emergency lockdown. My security codes won't work.
Don't worry. T3 can slice through any security system.
He better hurry. I don't sense guards on the other side of the door.
You think they fled?
I think when the alarms went off, Nyriss told them to execute the prisoner.
Hurry, do it! Come on, just do it. What's the problem?
Shut up. You were too scared to even open the cell.
Set the weapon down if you want to live.
No, he'll kill us.
I promise to spare you. I give you my word as a Jedi.
See? I told you he was a Jedi.
Nyriss has sent you on a suicide mission. Now put the gun down and walk away from this.
We can't walk away. This level has been locked down.
Just shoot him. He can't hurt you. If he was gonna stop you, he would have done it by now.
Nyriss will kill us if she finds us down here with you still alive.
Do you not hear the explosions? The alarms? My friends are coming to liberate me. What do you think they will do if they find you standing over my corpse?
I'm sorry.
Squeeze that trigger again, and it will be the last action you ever take. Oh, and you might want to move. Now, stand over there against that wall until my friends arrive. You don't want them to mistake you for a threat. Trust me. Mitra. About damn time.
I knew I'd find you.
Do I want to know about the outfit?
It's best if you don't.
A touching reunion.
It's okay. Scourge is here to help us.
So I get to finally learn your name. Scourge. No wonder you didn't want to tell me.
Make your jokes once we're safely away from here.
He's right. T3 is keeping watch at the end of the hall. We need to leave.
Go ahead. I'll take care of the witnesses.
No. I promised to protect them.
It's going to be hard enough to get out of here without escorting these pathetic excuses for soldiers.
I gave them my word.
What's wrong?
Ask him. I just need a minute.
This will help, but it'll take a few minutes. I have something else. You had it with you when I took you from your ship.
Is that...
My mask, yes. It's the one I wore during the Mandalorian Wars, and for some time after.
But I thought it was lost when the Jedi strike team captured you.
Bastila led that strike team. I don't know why, but she took the mask when I fell, and she kept it all this time.
But why give it to you now?
Well, we didn't know if we would see each other again, so she wanted me to take it with me. That mask is a symbol of my dark past. She wanted to keep it hidden from me, in case it would trigger something in my mind. Rekindle the spark of the dark side. But after defeating Malak, I realized that past is part of who I am. And Bastila did too. I think she hoped it would bring back more of what I lost. Restore more of my memories. But I don't need the mask for that. Returning here was enough.
Returning?
What's happening?
I don't know. He must be having a reaction to whatever you gave him. Revan! Someone's coming.
Ready your blaster, T-Fools. We need to protect Revan.
So, you stand with Revan. You've made a fatal mistake, Lord Scourge. And what's this? Another Jedi? The Imperial Guard will make sure I never leave my stronghold alive. But neither will any of you. I would be as easy to defeat as Zedrix. I am Darth Nihrus, Lord of the Sith, Conqueror of Drezzy, the Destroyer of Mildia, and a member of the Dark Council. Gaze upon me and see your doom.
Now look at me, Sith. I am Revan Reborn, and before me, you are nothing.
You're right. We don't want the Imperial Guard to know you are here.
Here. This is yours.
Get us out of here.
We should be safe here. Where are you going?
To contact my servant back in Kaas City. I'll see if I can learn any more details about the attack. If we're lucky, the Emperor has spread his resources too thin, leaving him vulnerable. Now might be the time to strike. I'll be right back.
I'm sure you're eager to change out of those clothes.
We have something to show you first. T3 came across a holovid in the archives on Coruscant. She must have hoped you'd eventually see the message.
I don't know if you'll ever see this, but I have to believe you'll return someday. And when you do, I thought you'd want to see how fast your son was growing up. Say hi to your father.
Hello, father.
Coming home.
Lord Scourge, you can imagine my surprise when we arrived at Nyriss's compound, but you and the Jedi were nowhere to be found.
There was a complication.
A minor one, I hope. The Emperor would be very displeased to learn you have betrayed him.
I am with the Jedi now. They do not suspect anything. I will bring them before you as planned.
They?
Another Jedi has arrived to join them, but they will be no trouble, I assure you.
I don't find your tone very convincing.
The Jedi believe we are planning an attack on the Emperor. They will willingly follow me to our Lord's throne room. Just make sure the Imperials let us pass.
Very well, Lord Scourge. You will have your clear entrance to the Citadel.
My people will be watching you very closely.
And what of Nyriss and her followers?
Dead. They all are. Say goodbye to your father.
Goodbye, Father.
I love you, Logan.
I love you too. Of course. I'll watch it 100 times over if I can. But give me a minute. Thank you for this, and for saving me.
Honestly, it was nothing.
No, no. Do not underestimate all you have accomplished. Nobody else could have found me across the galaxy. Nobody else could have saved me from imprisonment. I was told you were cut off from the Force, but I can sense its power in you. I always knew you had great potential, but you have become far greater than I could ever have imagined.
I'm just following in your footsteps.
Not anymore. You have blazed your own trail now. I can sense you have walked a path that even I dare not tread. I owe you everything, Mitra. It is a debt I will never be able to repay.
No, without your teaching, I could never have become who I am. I am the one who owes a debt she can never repay.
Then why don't we call it even?
A wise and just solution, as always.
Would you like to watch the Holovid of Bastila and my son with me? It would mean more to watch it with a friend by my side.
Of course. It would be my honor. So what did you find out?
It wasn't just Nyriss who was attacked. The Emperor killed them all.
Her stronghold was in shambles when we fled. I'm not surprised her followers perished with it.
You misunderstand. Not just Nyriss and her followers. He killed all of them. All of the Dark Council. He wanted to send a message no one would ever forget. News of the massacre spread quickly. Thousands are trying to flee for their lives, fearing we are on the brink of war, but the Emperor has declared martial law and imposed a curfew over the entire city. Ships are forbidden to land or leave, and all off-world communications have been shut down.
He's quarantined the entire planet. He wants to get everything back here under control before any other worlds hear of what he has done.
You told me he was mad, but thousands of his people are going to die before order is restored.
You don't understand. The last time I was here, I peered into the depths of the Emperor's mind. 1,000 lives mean nothing to him.
And now with Nyriss and the rest of the Council destroyed, there are none left to oppose him. Nathima was just the beginning. He will destroy world after world, his power and madness growing in concert until he alone is left.
I'm afraid he's right. The Emperor has become obsessed with power and immortality. The dark side is like a cancer inside him. It grows faster than he can feed it. He has already consumed an entire world, yet he still hungers. And with this hunger comes an all-consuming fear, a fear of death.
A hunger for the Force. I know this all too well. The Republic almost perished already from the hunger of a Sith Lord, a disciple of Kreia and the Traeus Academy, Darth Nihilus. Perhaps there is a connection between him and your Emperor.
Wait, but that would mean...
It would mean that the Emperor has already been in Republic space. When I spoke to him, he briefly touched my mind. I saw visions of a shadow-covered world on the Outer Rim, fighting against the crushing force of his own gravity.
Malachor V.
The Emperor's power has spawned from the teachings of that place, and I fear his power will only grow stronger with each new world he annihilates. That is why it's important we defeat him here now, before his power grows beyond what we are able to stop.
I was able to defeat one disciple from that place already. Perhaps I can use my abilities to help defeat your Emperor.
What do you mean?
You told me you could sense my power, but that's not exactly true. It's the power of many, not just my own. I draw upon the force of others, just as Nihilus did, and I can use that ability to help cancel out your Emperor's power.
So this is our plan, using a force vampire to find a force black hole.
It has worked before, and unlike your Emperor, Nihilus didn't need a mass sacrifice to command that massive power over the dark side.
She does make a good point. At the very least, she could weaken him if he tries to use his power.
That's a risky plan, Jedi.
No more risky than walking us right into the throne room.
The Emperor believes I am still loyal to him. That will allow me to escort you right into the Citadel, as my prisoners. But you will have to go in, unarmed.
I know, T3. I don't like this either.
Mitra, it's fine. Really, T3 will be with us.
Very well. It's decided then. We should wait until dawn.
Perfect. That gives us a few hours to try to get some rest.
You two go ahead. I'll be along shortly. All right, T3. Let's run it back.
I don't know if you'll ever see this, but I have to believe you'll return someday. And when you do, I thought you'd want to see how fast your son was growing up. Say hi to your father.
Where is your captain?
She is coming.
I will not be kept waiting. I demand you open these doors immediately.
What is going on here?
Your guards blocking my path. That's what's going on here.
Captain Yari, Lord Scourge demands to meet with the Emperor.
Perhaps Lord Scourge should remember his manners.
I do not take my orders from you, Captain.
In the Citadel you do. Now, the Emperor is waiting, but first, let me see who you have brought with you. You there, face me.
The captain asked you.
Don't touch me.
You, assassins! Kill them all!
T3! Stop coming.
Mandalorian did you have to kill for that?
Once you're dead, you can ask him yourself.
I did not expect your return.
I haven't. The old Revan is dead, and you'll soon be joining him.
Foolish Jedi. I have survived for millennia, undisturbed, unchallenged, and now I will show you why.
Ready in the throne room. Let's go.
Going somewhere, traitor?
Revan needs our help.
Goodbye, Revan. I expected better from you, Lord Scourge.
He has seen the depths of your evil. He stands with us now.
Then he will die with you as well.
You can't defeat all three of us.
And I know the truth about your power, and how to stop you.
You know nothing. Explain yourself.
My lord, the Jedi were working for Nyriss. Revan claimed he had once been your servant, but that he had returned to destroy you. When the second Jedi arrived, I knew I was not strong enough to defeat both of them myself, So I lured them here to face you.
Why didn't you mention this when you told me about Nyriss's betrayal?
I didn't know there were two of them. I only found out after the guard raised her stronghold. The Jedi sought me out. They knew I worked for Nyriss. They never suspected that I was the one who had betrayed her.
So you led them here?
Yes, my Lord Emperor. I knew they could never defeat you, so I played along, waiting for my chance to turn on them and prove my loyalty to you once more.
If this is true, then you must finish it. Put away your blade. You have passed my test. Revan can still be of use to me.
Twice I have stopped those who sought to defeat you. I trust you will remember this when you select the members of the new Dark Council.
I promise you will be given your just reward. Before you depart, Lord Scourge, I have one more question.
What is it?
Why kill Captain Yari?
My lord?
The head of my Imperial Guard. I've been working with her. If you were loyal to the Empire, why kill her?
I was hoping you hadn't noticed that. Your affinity for using the Force betrays you, my lord. Yes, I know who you are, Vitiate. And I know who you are not.
How dare you address—
Be silent. Your time is over. Your entire government has already fallen. And your army of blind disciples will soon follow. When we are finished here today, there will be nothing left of your regime. The planet shall be cleansed of all opposition. Then its true heirs shall take their rightful place. In our customs, only the strong shall rule. I see only weakness in you. Lord Revan, oh, how easy it was to control you. You, the savior of the galaxy. You Jedi are pathetic. If you are the best they have to offer, then we will barely break a sweat as we sweep across the Republic and ravage your worlds. You know who I am, but not what I am. I am that which has emerged from the shadows. A forgotten power, reignited again, the descendant of Naga Sadow, and successor of this false ruler, the true Sith, have returned. And our numbers will only multiply as we exact our vengeance. It's nearly daylight. Are you ready to leave?
I am. But you're not coming with us.
Mitra, what have you done?
I just saved you. Again.
Wait, what are you talking about?
That Sith scum was playing us, leading us right into a trap.
I don't understand.
I had a terrible vision. But the Force has given us both a second chance.
Look, you're not making any sense.
You died, Revan. We both did. We played right into Scourge's hands.
And now Scourge is dead. But it's not finished. The Emperor still remains.
You don't understand. We can't go to the Citadel.
And why not?
Because the Emperor isn't the true threat. He isn't true anything. He never was. You've been misled from the moment you set foot on this planet all those years ago. This whole time, you've been fighting to understand your actions, to regain those memories that would allow you to bring some closure to your dark past. But it was all a lie, just like the Emperor. The true Sith are coming, and they will soon reclaim this planet for themselves.
No, I don't believe that.
My vision couldn't have been clearer. You, of all people, should understand the power they hold.
Look, I don't doubt you. It's just hard to accept. The Emperor set in motion every event in my life for the past 10 years. I've destroyed enemies because of him. Destroyed friendships because of him. And now I'm here because of him. He must pay for what he has done.
And he will, but not by you. This is bigger than him right now. Bigger than you. Bigger than all of us. We need to warn the Republic, or what we know and love will fall. Who we know and love will fall.
Bastila.
She's waiting for you. Come with me. Help me save her. Help me save your son.
The Emperor still has the planet on lockdown. We'd have to outrun the Imperial patrols.
That's not going to be a problem with the old girl at our disposal.
You brought the Ebon Hawk? You never cease to surprise me, Mitra.
You told me not to underestimate myself. You should learn not to underestimate me either.
I guess I shouldn't.
Call it even.
A wise and just solution. Let's go.